Hi, I'm Steve Jones, and I'm going to tell you something about mathematical symbols. Now, obviously, if you're going to count, then you can do it verbally, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it's very easy. But if you want to convey that information to somebody else, you need some way of doing it. And fairly obviously, also, the Greeks and Romans came up with similar systems. Not altogether surprising, since most Romans also spoke Greek, or educated Romans spoke Greek. So here the symbols are simple representations. 1 is a single stroke, 2 is 2 strokes, 3 is 3 strokes, 4 is 4 strokes. The trouble is, when we get to 596, we have a big problem in deciding what the number is, because 596 strokes does not make a sensible thing to work with. So we have to convey a meaning without actually putting all of the counting in it. So the meaning, so we get to 5 and we have a single digit for 5 in both forms. The problem with the Greeks was they couldn't agree on what the form should be. So each different state had its own form, and therefore the Greeks were in a confusion over counting. The Romans didn't have a problem, although you probably are aware that often where the Roman 4 is, you will see 4 vertical lines like the Greek one. And also the 9 also can be represented in the same way. So that's a similarity. These systems were very effective for doing what the Romans and the Greeks wanted. Unfortunately, later on, things were developing so rapidly that you needed a quicker number system. And therefore, to create a set of individual digits from 0 to 9, but I've just done here 1 up to 10, so from 0 to 9 are the individual digits. This again makes representing big numbers much easier. Big Roman numbers were quite cumbersome, would involve lots and lots of digits, whereas modern Arabic numbers involve just 4, 5, 6, 7 digits. A big number will contain many more, of course, but they are reasonable numbers. But these aren't the only symbols that we used. Obviously, we needed symbols to tell us what to do. And some of the important ones are these, which you are probably familiar with. These are the operations symbols, or operators. We have minus, plus, divide, and multiply. And these came quite late. These were not early developments. Once we have these, we can operate on our counting numbers, but still we can't actually do mathematics. And for that, we need developments like those of Leibniz, and at the same time, Newton and people in Britain were doing the same thing, where we developed the calculus notation. Each time we need new symbols to represent new things, new operations. These are objects. This is an operation. So we need special symbols all the time to develop our mathematics. And some of the most interesting ones are things like this, which we know as infinity. Nobody's ever been able to define what infinity is, but we have a symbol for it. In other words, we can write a symbol for something that is impossible to imagine, like most of mathematics.